Walker in the outfield. Roland, Renteria, Womack, and Bulls. Third to first, a battery of Morris and Matheny. Since the LCS went to a best-of-seven format in 85, 10 teams have been in the same position as the Cardinals, heading into Game 6, down 3-2. In 7 of the 10 cases, the road team won Game 6 to wrap up the series.
The solidity of his running is beautiful.
Hooked into short left field. It's going to fall in a base hit. Beltran had to hold up to make sure. And here come the Astros. That throw way offline from Sanders back into the infield. And
offensively right now.
In the air down the left field line. This will easily bring in Beltran. Caught by Sanders. And Houston has taken a 1-0 lead in his game 6 of the National League Championship Series. Berkman with 12 postseason. On the ground to Roland. Bobbles, throws, and still gets back well at second. Championship Series trailing 1-0. And 29-year-old journeyman right-hander Pete Monroe delivers strike one to Tony Womack. Base hit in the right field, only the fourth in this postseason for Tony Womack. It up into right field. It should end the inning, and it does. 3-2 again. There goes Vizcaino. Strike three. Throw to second. And Ausmus will be tagged out. On the ground, right at Vizcaino. He'll throw to first, and that will end the inning. A two-out single by Womack. We go to the third. Thinking he's going to catch the ball in the air. Blistered down to left field line by Bagwell. Ricochets off the facing, then goes into left center field. And Beltran stumbles around third, but he will score. The little nooks and crannies in every ballpark can make a difference. Liner caught by Renteria in the inning. Now the Bulls will lead off the third against Peter Monroe. First pitch swinging, blasted into right center field. And it's up against the wall. Pulls into second base with a double. Edmonds' first pitch swinging, pops it up into left field. Now Pulls going back to the bag to tag up. And here he comes. Here comes the throw from Biggio. Not in time. Takes over on the mound. See his numbers in this postseason. In games 4 and 5. That one's shot in the right field. It's a fair ball and going into the corner. Renteria on his way to third. They'll hold him there. Three, two again. Struck him out on a breaking ball. Big pitch, big out right there for Chad Harville. Two gone in the inning and a back. Fastball paints the outside corner at 96 miles. It's been very quiet this entire series. This one hammered into right field after missing foul a moment ago. He doesn't miss this time. Lamb is second hit in this LCS, and both have gone for home runs. Well, he hit a ball into the upper deck, foul on the last. Biggio lifts a fly ball into right field, playable for Larry Walker to end the inning. A home run by Lamb makes makes it a 4-3 Cardinal lead. Now taking over on the mound. He allowed 5 hits and 5 runs in 1 inning of game 1. Chad Qualls.
Well, not that he needs us to defend him, but some of those 5 hits were leaders, broken back, ground balls.
Dominating during that period of time. Well, they have a lot of confidence in his ability.
Good looking fastball that paints the inside black to Larry Walker. 2 gone. That's a fair ball. And again, it ricochets off the padding, and this may be another run. Pujols going to be held at the last second and runs through the stop sign. And he is out at the plate. What a marvelous play by Brad Ausmus. Went 20 feet to his left from where he set up. Had to go get the ball and tags him out to end.
He gets the ball. You hold the runner. If the infielder going out gets the ball, then maybe you take a chance and send him.
And Matt Morris shuts down Belton, Bagwell, and Berkman in order. After 4, how they may have an effect on the outcome of this series. I mean, let's face it. As Renteria is going on strike.
Sit back and watch home run derby.
1-2 pitch. And the inning is over. So they hit for Morris. Hill and Qualls for Houston. And now taking over for Matt Morris, the left-hander Ray King.
The numbers in this series, not
1-2. Back to the mound. Could be 2. There's 1. That's another play. But of course, Pettitte's had a lot more games to pitch in.
Yep.
Kiko Calero takes over. And in this league championship series, Calero has been 2-2 pitch. Right back to the mound. Calero takes care of the sixth inning. 2 hits, a man left.
We have problems corralling a ball.
Lamb making sure this time. And a 1-2-3-6 for Qualls. We're back to St. Louis after a inning. And he pops up the first pitch. Walker coming hard. And makes the right play to end the inning. Kiko Calero. Wheeler again, a 3-2. Got him swinging for the second out of the inning. Here is today's game. Popped up. At Biggio in left field. You saw him talking to himself. He said, hit it to me. And that'll end the inning. Only twice all year is Jason Isringhausen. Tony La Russa will hand the ball to his closer, Jason Isringhausen.
And it's not unexpected to them.
Hammered down the left field line by Kent Taguchi, trying to cut it off, and he bobbles the ball, which will allow Kent to get into second base. Not that he wouldn't have otherwise, but if he cuts that ball. Came in there again and got him swinging.
Kent's got to get an aggressive lead.
Little pop up right side. Who wants it? Luna's got it. Final end of the inning. Tying run stranded at second. Cardinals back. Strike 3 call. Paints the inside corner. And Wheeler. And it results in a pop up. Vizcaino makes a play. Ausmus, a pinch hitter. Then Biggio against Isringhausen. Cardinals 3. And he's hit with a pitch to begin the inning. Can't roll it out there any better than that. Pujols thought about second and just does get the out at first. So nicely done by Brundtland. Sending the tying run into. The last time Jason Isringhausen intentionally walked a batter to pitch to the next batter, he walked Berkman to face Kent. That was it. Bagwell hammers the first pitch. It'll fall in a base hit. Racing home is Ensberg, and Bagwell delivers. A 4-4 game in the ninth inning. Astros closer who has been nothing shy of phenomenal during this postseason. Brad Lidge The one run he gave to the Roland struck him out.
If you're a Cardinal fan, you're hoping that that's true, because so far Lidge has been
getting over. 9-0, down a strike. Broken bat, Roller. And Isringhausen will get to the bat. Sharp. 10th inning for the Cardinal closer. Renteria will start things. They'll hit for the pitcher. We go to the 11th inning. As Chavez makes a throw down to first, Lidge strikes out the batter to end the inning. Tavares had an out Eastern time. Swing and hit. There's that slider. Little drop down action that time by Julian. 7 in the series. On the ground, Renteria arranging it as well.
Perfect. And try to take a few strikes, put some base runners against him.
Because doesn't look like you're going to hit him. Then Brad Lidge, who shuts down the side in order in the 11th. He faces. Rolling and Edmonds coming up. We're back after a break from your local Fox station. And now taking over on the mound. We've only seen him once in a series. Right-hander Dan Mazzelli. He got the loss in game two. Nowhere close.
Now the point now being, you don't need one swing of the bat to beat you anymore. You do if there's nobody on. Once you have base runners on, a gapper can beat you.
A mile high and playable for Chavez. One away. We're rolling up there. First pitch hacking after a four-pitch walk to Poole. You gotta wonder. Edmonds hit 42 home runs during the regular season.